Chairman asked me, said,
"Bring it on."
Where's he at?
Call the meeting to order. First item is public comment from anybody.
Well, yeah, I got a couple, divided precincts Wednesday. Is that true or?
It's on the agenda.
Can I get a map of what it's gonna look like?
Not yet. Still a work in progress.
Oh, can I have it Wednesday?
Assuming it's a finished product, I'd be more than happy to get it to you Wednesday.
Yeah, we should vote so far.
Certainly.
I read something about somebody contemplating a county park district. Are you guys got anything to do with that?
In the paper.
It was in the paper.
All I know is I read the article in the paper.
I don't know if you guys have been talking about it. I'm here to ask you not to talk about it, since it's another tax grab. We had tornado warnings in the county last night. As in years past, nobody is getting the warnings on their phones.
I did.
Nobody, people I talked to in Kansas didn't. I didn't.
That's not nobody.
Christmas didn't. And the last time I did, I went up to the emergency management place. He looked at the database and saw my phone number in there, and I still didn't get the message.
Maybe they don't like it.
So could you ask them nicely to run a test message to at least verify that it's working and calling people, and to give the citizens of the county a little more confidence in the system that you're using? My personal opinion is we never should have got rid of the dang sirens anyway, but at least a test message prior to normal springtime bad weather would give people a little more confidence in the system that you're using. Nobody I know, I've talked to at least 10 people, got, yeah, see, we got it. Maybe he gave it to you because you're a county board member.
That's never meant a whole lot.
You got yours as a text.
Yeah, I got mine as a text.
I got mine sent to the home phone and it rang.
But I get it from WTHI, but.
Go ahead.
So, and I never got that. So please ask them to do a test message. I know it costs a little bit, but people have a little more confidence.
That's your committee. You're chairman of that.
No, I'm not.
You're not chairman of that?
Nope.
If you can, I'm sure she will be there Wednesday.
I think he is.
Bring it up again, and we'll have a discussion about it.
Is that office open during the day?
No, I'm not.
I'll go by and just double check. I'll go by and make sure my phone's in there, because the last time he brought up the map of where the phones that he called, and I was within that map, and it still didn't call me, he didn't know why.
Her office is open from 8 to 12, it's supposed to be.
Well, after the meeting, I'll go up there and see, make sure my number's still.
What's the lady's name?
Yeah, that's Jill.
Jill?
Jill.
Taylor.
Taylor.
She's the.
I'll just make sure my number, I know it's in there.
Did yours come through as a text? Mine came through as something, but then when I went to open it, it wasn't a text, and I couldn't find it anywhere, but that was.
Sometimes what service you have, it comes through as an immediate message, and sometimes can't open it.
Right, I couldn't.
It was an MMS.
I had three others, so I opened them, and it was gone, man, so.
And finally, I'm gonna close my comments with somewhat of a compliment. I appreciate you guys keeping the expenses down. And the reason why I'm saying this is because I don't know if you're familiar with the county that's north of here, several counties. I believe it's Kankakee County, but last fall, they laid off 54 deputies because they couldn't afford to pay them. Now they're so far in debt, they've maxed out their tax anticipation money they could borrow. They can't make payroll this week, and they have close to $5 million in overdue vendor invoices they haven't paid. That's the word I got from a county board member up there, so I appreciate you guys working on the budget the way you're. At least we're not in their shoes. So that's the end of my comment.
Who's in charge of this?
Jill.
Jill.
not let the...
Who's the chairman of that committee?
I couldn't tell you.
Well, see, I was.
Andy is.
Andy is? Okay. I knew it wasn't that.
I knew it wasn't new. I'm on it, I think.
That was a finance committee?
It's you, me, and Andy that's on it.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll get off the hill and talk to her anyway.
But that would be a good idea, you know, to do a test message, you know, now that tornadoes...
They do one every once in a while.
Who's the chairman?
They used to. I don't know if they still do.
Yeah.
I think I got one last year.
I used to get them, but I don't get them anymore for some reason.
I got one a couple months ago.
Phone call.
Yeah.
You register your number only or your name and number? So she, you look up your name and see...
Should be my name and number.
And number, okay.
I'll go up there.
I was gonna say, I don't think that'd be the courteous, I mean...
I'll check to make sure it's in the phone, it's in their system. It wasn't last time.
And that may be something, if it's not, that may be something for people to call.
Morning, guys. My name is Rob Bogue. I'm a citizen of the United States of America and I'm a resident of Edgar County. I wanted to visit with you folks this morning about the airport issues. Lisa's gone, that's good, I think, because of how she was hired and how she came into Edgar County. Jerry Griffin still at the airport. Jerry has some problems with his qualifications, his work history. He's not an AMP. That's a status he's been purveying as one that he has. He wasn't very forthcoming or truthful about the crash of 736AA. So, in ordinary circumstances, he shouldn't be employed. I hope you folks are working on that. I wanted to talk again about the, or at least about something a little different than I had in the past, that's the grant application. My math is correct. You have a grant application on file for $1,110,325 with the Division of Aeronautics, FAA. That is a concrete project, primarily a concrete project. Requires a $40,000 participation from the state of Illinois and another $70,000 from the county, Edgar County. My math is correct. I think this are the good numbers, but if I'm not, someone correct me, please. Last year, when the county sold off a transportation facility, they're going to end the year in a deficit, and because of that money being returned to the county, the budget ended in good shape. But this year, you don't have that to sell off. So we're talking about a $70,000 investment here. From what little I know and understand, that's a lot of money for Edgar County residents to pay. That's on top of the $100,000 plus commitment the county makes to keep that airport in operation. Now that may be offset by lease. Lease is on, you could, Jeff, you got something to say? You're right. My concerns are as follows. First of all, this is money that we don't have. I don't believe this is money we got. So it may ultimately result in a countywide tax increase. I don't want a tax increase if that's the case. The other things about this grant are, it's not needed. There are not 16 aircraft, and that was what you declared on the grant application. There are 16 aircraft present at that airport. Now that may have been true February 13, 2012, but it is not true today. So that is an inaccuracy, if you will, the same as the last time around with this kind of a grant thing. So I'm asking that you look at this grant application. Think about what happened last year. I don't believe it's going to happen this year on this grant the way it's proposed. I think your money's better spent on highways. Thank you.
Anybody else?
Can I say one other thing, and I'll be real quick, it's about income that the county can get. There's still one issue with that mass transit district out there, and it's the property that was transferred to the Edgar County, whatever organization was, that turned around and made $60,000 selling it back to NAL. That $60,000 is the county's, not that nonprofit. I can't remember the name of it.
PIDCO? Or was it
Edgar County something? Paris Economic Development. That's PIDCO. They transferred that back to PIDCO for $15,000, what they paid for it. PEDCO turned around and sold that thing, is my understanding, for $75,000 to NAL for their parking lot. That money stays with the county. They didn't have the authority to transfer the property to begin with. and it's still out there, and it's a loose end that needs to be wrapped up. I'm trying to give you guys some money, you just have to work for it.
Okay, committee reports, Mr. Zuber.
Okay, one is, went to the Regional Office of Education meeting the other night, and what they're proposing for this year's budget, because they're faced with a lot of same stuff, are they're actually going to try to keep those exactly the same. So there won't be an increase as far as budget. Still, the total budget as far as the regional office over there for office operations is still going to be about $285,000, and we still spend 12.96%. So that's going to be about the same. So that's, and that's not yet approved, but we'll probably approve that at the next meeting. A little bit of update on insurance type of stuff. The general timeline for health insurance, our health insurance effective date is October 1st. And what we're looking at now is probably just trying to renew the coverage instead of totally rebidding the process. What they found over the years, if you rebid the process all the time, unless you're unhappy with your company or unless your people are unhappy or whatever, you could do it probably once every 2 to 3 years. Because then those companies supposedly bid a little bit differently because they don't think they're going to have any continuity. So therefore, they don't have a chance to, I guess, equalize their losses or, in my mind, equalize their gains. But anyway, so that's something that we'd probably be looking at when I discuss with you guys today. I think the general plan would be to probably just renew the coverage, and then we could see what their renewal rates are toward the end of July. And if they're with what we consider within a normal range, we go with it. And that way also all of our employees don't have to go back through and write down all the documentation, apply all over again, and do all that other stuff like they had to last year. So again, that's something a little bit different, but that is something that is pretty common within the industry now. Most of these things is vet out every 2 or 3 years. So I throw that out there for possibilities. Other thing, of course, speaking of airport, our airport liability coverage is effective September 25th. We ought to be all right there from that standpoint, I'm hoping, because I don't know what you guys did within that framework at the airport. But the processes, I think, started in April, and they were hopefully to get that in mid-June as far as the complete and return those. So I don't know who that is, but. Workman's comp still, of course, is effective January 1st. We'll probably start a little bit of bid process on that if we decide to bid again in July or August of that. Our package liability, effective December 1st. So as we look at that, if we, again, we'll try to get the bid specs out to all interested bidding agents mid-August of 2015. All I did was just kind of get a little mini calendar. But the main thing I want to talk about was the health insurance aspect of the idea of, like, even if we decide to renew the coverage, that doesn't mean that we have accepted that. What that means is that we're going to say, okay, we're basically looking for a renewal. And what we found over the last couple of years is that there's really only one major player in Blue Cross Blue Shield.
You probably read the article about
that. That really doesn't have anything to do with us in Illinois. I checked into that. You may have read something. About 23% in North Carolina. Ours is totally based on Illinois and our scenario and our claims, more so than anything else. It's our claims. So if you remember last year we got through that, we had kind of a little click for being in Illinois, a little click for where we live at in Illinois in comparison to our health facilities around us, and then the click for our past claims. So that's what those are. So, questions about insurance in general?
Did we talk about maybe changing the number of options for the employees, or is that going to be
the same? If we just renew the coverage, everything would stay basically the same. We probably have some flexibility. What we found last year, as you guys kind of remembered, we tried to give more flexibility to more employees, and actually nobody really took any of that. One of the issues that we're looking at from an insurance perspective is basically provide what's necessary to provide. Let people choose, because, you know, that's the issue we got into last year, in my mind, is for people who take it, insurance advantage, it's a real advantage. And then depending on the program they are involved with, it could be more advantage to a lot of other people. So well, that's something we always beat around the bush all the time. We're going to try to do anything with that, or we're not going to try to do anything with that. That would be the question in my mind, Dan, more than anything else. Are we going to try to equalize the amount of benefit that all the employees have to try to make it kind of the same all over? So I think there's I haven't seen the email back on that. I know they're trying to get a hold of you guys in your office. Is there a meeting set for in June yet for the insurance meeting?
I cannot confirm that.
Okay.
I know there was something there, but...
Not to your knowledge. They're trying to set up we try to set up a every month or every 2 month meeting with Bushu and also the crew in the county to hopefully try to alleviate any questions or not, and have anybody who wants to in the county from the office standpoint go and talk to them. And I know they've been trying to set up a meeting within that state framework for last week and a half or so. So I didn't know if it was finalized, but that would be something I hope we get continued also, because that's a in that way, they also keep us up with the Affordable Care Act, too. Mr. Vice Chairman, I think that's all I have, unless somebody else has questions.
Just something to keep in mind, you know, we've got union contracts. Both of them are up this year, and, you know, that's a part of, you know, the health insurance. That would be an issue.
Mm-hmm. So, and that goes back to that other issue of how much we pay differently for different people, and the rest of them aren't contractual, so I don't know if we ever want to really get into that or not, but
so just keep in mind. Check.
Okay, let's see. From the assessor's office, the tax bills will be mailed this afternoon. Last year they were mailed on 6/20.
A lot of people.
So we're about 2 weeks ahead of time. The due dates are still the same as what they were last year, but it's possible that distributions can take place sooner because we'll start getting money in sooner. Additionally, by going out and verifying homestead exemptions and senior citizen exemptions, we were able to put $830,000 worth of evaluation back on the tax rolls. Okay. Audit. I don't see it on the agenda. We may have to have a special meeting for, unless I missed it, August.
I didn't either. On the 4/20 Wednesdays?
We're going to have to probably, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to.
Yeah, I thought I had it on there.
I can check with him to make sure we can't slide. We'll have to find out how long our extension was. Maybe we can do it in July, but it's a possibility. My question was, I wanted to make sure that everybody had a chance to look at the audit, and if they had any questions, we need to address them. The management letters, we're going to discuss with a couple of departments because of the specifics that was involved with, the Finance Committee will. Budget-wise, Finance Committee, we're talked to Don, and I haven't talked to Augie yet because they've been busy with tax bills and everything else, but we're probably planning to get out the budget outline to all the departments, elected officials, in July with an early September turnback so that we're not rushed. And that way we have time to meet with and discuss those who have issues and questions. As far as the budget, at this point in time, with two payrolls added in, we're at 48.4% of the year in expenditures against 58% of the year gone by. So we're doing okay. We're ahead of last year in comparison. As far as cash flow, the cash flow, including $110,000 borrowed, actually more than that, and you'll see this on Wednesday, we were $41,000 positive, and this year we're $172,000, including the payroll. So we're doing well. We may have to, however, borrow some money for the IMRF fund. And remember, we're still recovering from last year. This should be the last time we'll have to do it, because our funds last year had borrowed, well, like I said, $109,000, and this year they're positive $98,000. So we're doing pretty good there.
So did he didn't have to borrow any?
Not yet.
Okay, that's what it.
Not yet. And it's possible, if we have enough money in the Fund 100 and the general funds, we may be able to squeak by on IMRF without borrowing. We just don't know, okay? Let's see, make sure I've got everything here. Okay, on the airport, we have an airport meeting tonight. The advisory board meets at 6:30 out at the airport. One of the items that is going to be discussed, and I wanted to brief you fellows on this, is that a gentleman by the name of Warren Hubbard, I met with him midweek, I can't tell you which day. He wanted to meet with me, and Jerry set it up. He and his company are interested in leasing acreage at the airport long term for him to construct facilities, permanent facilities for spray-based agricultural spray. Without getting into specifics that might be part of negotiations, he is very excited about it. I've talked to him several times since then, and I guess what we need to do is not commit to it, but at least get a consensus that we're interested in talking to the gentleman, set up a negotiating team, which may or may not be the airport committee. With Ben not here, I have discussed it obviously with Ben, and I've discussed it individually with the airport committee, not as a group. And we need to talk to the advisory committee, get their viewpoint, and then if everybody is positive about it, start to meet with this gentleman and find out what's possible and what's not.
Do you have a base somewhere else?
He has several bases all over the world, actually. So he's they're not a small item. So at any rate, I wanted to make sure you all were aware of it, number one, so that you can start forming an opinion. I've talked to Hanson's Engineering about facility or land availability, and there is out there, and there for him or other people for the expansion of the airport, which was what was planned. So
in essence, this is just an extenuation of Mills, of what we had hoped Mills would do and what Mills had tentatively talked about doing.
Right. This is just a furtherance. My understanding is that this gentleman did go over and meet with Peggy and Jim to make sure, I guess the better way to put it is, he wasn't stepping on their toes. And there doesn't seem to be any issues, but I think ultimately, we need to make sure of that ourselves, and then talk to them. But anyway, no, you're fine.
Did you say there's a possibility that he would want to long-term lease with the possibility of building something also?
Oh, he wants to build.
That's what.
And I'm trying to avoid specifics,
yeah,
okay?
Right,
but I mean, they would meet if they're a permanent facility, which is that I don't have a problem with saying. Talking about a permanent facility, which means he would have to meet EPA and Department of Illinois agricultural requirements for holding and handling and all that other stuff. So, okay, so he is aware of that and he's excited about it. So that's where we're at on that deal.
And there's probably several parcels out there that this could be. It's just something that Hanson probably has to.
Right.
This guy wants to be, I understand, as close to the runway as possible to save time when they get to going.
But then you have to think about infrastructure, water, utilities, everything else has to be taken into consideration there also. So, and you know, if you have to look at it kind of as a future development too. You know, it's there might be, once you get one, maybe that's possible to
get
others.
Did he give you any idea, Jeff, what size initially he was talking about?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. But again, that can change, you know, and it's not a small facility.
Right.
Okay, so. I know there's questions, but.
Gasoline, would it buy gas from us?
No, actually, that is one thing, it's negotiable, but he understands that if he does not buy gasoline from us or have gas or whatever, that there would be a parlor fee. And they've got no problem with that, okay?
I mean, Brian makes as much money off of that.
Yeah, right, I think we'll say that.
Well, at any rate, but they, his company buys a lot of fuel, a lot of fuel, so.
And probably they couldn't get to, they're going to be so fast, it's going to be, take them less time to fuel their own than go to the pumps and get them, so.
But at any rate, I mean, that's those and a myriad of other things we're going to have to ask questions about.
Okay.
And settle them. I mean, if we ultimately say, as a group, that we're interested, okay? But I did let him know that I was going to be discussing it this week with the airport advisory board and with this board, and hopefully we can reach a consensus rather rapidly if we're interested in it, so we can start talking to
him. So somebody else can help. Would he be anticipating breaking ground this year?
He'd like to be ready for next year.
Okay.
Yep. And he has all kinds of products that you'd be interested in talking to him about that probably aren't in this area yet. Everything, the aflatoxin situation they've got all kinds of bioproducts that haven't been introduced in the Midwest yet that he's interested in introducing. So, I mean, it's not just going out and spraying corn. I mean, there's a lot more to it, okay? But I think you guys will find him interesting, and if we get to that point, I think it's, you know, certainly worth looking at.
They weren't going to come tonight, were they?
Oh, no. Everybody's...
Yeah, right.
We need to take this one. He's out of the country now anyway, so, okay? He's where my son is, so. Have I forgotten anything, guys? Help me. Airport, finance committee.
Well, I got an airport question. Maybe it's now the time to ask it. Maybe this has been asked before, and I just don't remember, but common sense, is there a reason that our county highway can't mow the airport property? Eventually this is going to happen. This is more of a question for the airport advisory committee, but still, it's going to fall on our lap anyway. Why we're going to have to revamp and maybe hire somebody, why can't we just send a county highway out there like they mow the ditches and mow this new area, that's new 56 that we've got, or whatever it is, 60 acres that we've reclaimed? Is that a possibility? I mean, they got mowers, they got people.
I understand that. The only other thing that I'd have wonder about that is delineation of cost.
Right.
I mean, I don't really care one way or the other, but I don't think that's something that should be put on the county highway as far as just an additional cost to do. I think that should be factored in somewhere so that we see exactly what the airport is doing for us or not doing for us, if that makes sense. I don't have a problem doing it. I mean,
a question that could be asked.
Yeah. I'm just trying to get it the cheapest way.
I'm just brainstorming. Okay. I'm just thinking.
Yeah.
Off the top.
I mean, rather than have to hire a contractor to go out there and mow it or pay Brad to mow it, I'm just thinking we've got mowers, we've got people, and can we make that work? It's just like, you know,
using highway tax money to do that.
Well.
The other thing, we're going to three different levels of mowing. And so far, we may be able to keep up with that.
Okay.
We need to give it a chance.
Right.
And we may have, like, we went to 14 inches and 8 inches and mow. Okay? So we need to give that a chance to see how that's going to work on a long-term basis. I think the only thing we've talked about having Brad doing is seeding at this point.
Okay, well, there had been some talk about Brad Mullen.
Absolutely, absolutely. But now that, but the advisory board is heading in a direction of different levels. I mean, we've been keeping, and it's not a problem, but we've been keeping that like a mowed yard all over the airport, and that's just not practical.
Right. And Mike, this goes back to an old age-old question I had. Why don't we plow the runways with the county highway equipment? And that there's a reason we don't do that too. You know, so I'm thinking it may be the same reason we can't mow. It might be because we can't.
I don't think it's we can't. I mean, it's just a standpoint of what makes the best sense for.
Right.
It's going to evolve. I mean, what's happening today may not happen in next year, but we just got to be flexible. It's not a bad question.
Okay.
No. I think I'll probably remember something in 5 minutes. But.
Me? I've got just a few things. Number one, I'm still waiting, and I've been in contact with the company that did the that is doing the estimate on the roof of the courthouse. I don't know, I got the feeling the longer it takes, the worse it is. But I don't know what the day that they did the estimate. I said, you know, what's the possibility of like painting the metal? And he goes, well, you got holes in the metal. He said,
use really thick paint.
Yeah.
I asked the same thing. I said, you asked the paint. He said, there's a problem with painting holes.
It doesn't fill the hole.
I'm still waiting to hear from him. He's gotten yet to get back with me. I got Mark Sullivan working on the sidewalk where we had some issues with the glass. He's cut out the old, I don't think he's.
Yeah, did he
put it back in? Yeah, okay. He just did it this week.
Right, I think. For Saturday, I was up there.
Okay. Is that at our? Is that some cost to us?
Or I can go back to it if you want.
Well,
I figure, Andy,
around on the other side too, there's ruts this deep in the side.
I just wondered if his insurance would cover any of it. I mean, he has to have contractor that's insurance. Because that can't be cheap.
No, we need to get that fixed.
Well, anyway, that's your deal.
I'm sorry.
It's Tom.
Okay. I haven't got the bill from Mark yet. I'll look into that and see what the option is on that.
I was just thinking, you know, when somebody's working at your house and breaks
something,
like
that.
Then they've got contractor insurance.
Did they tear out the? Did they tear out all that section or just patch that?
There's 3 sections.
Oh,
3 sections.
They poured all three back in.
And there's a couple other areas that have a little bit of damage done to it. It was just a heavy machine.
Oh yeah.
So there's a couple.
That concrete's older than Jeff Wood.
It is.
Jeff
Wood. Right. That's
but it's older than Jeff Wood too then.
Yeah.
You disturbed.
Anyway, I'll look into that.
Has Mark worked up on the attic?
What's up? Not yet. He's kind of got into this boat building out here at Simonton, and that was supposed to have been done over the winter, that nobody did anything, and then they all of a sudden came in and want everything done in like a month or a month and a half, and he's been covered up out there doing stuff, so he's assured me as soon as he's got, I mean, I think he's fairly close out there, that he'll come in and get that taken care of. He's got the stuff ordered to put it in. He's got the epoxy and the anchors and things, but he's just a little short on time right now. So, one more thing that you and I looked at too was the carpet in the courtroom. And I asked Bob. I said, "What's underneath that?" We went. Did you ever see it?
No.
You go back in the room to the left.
Okay.
There's it's like a basket weave tile. It's kind of pink. It's not really. It's not
was
bright.
It,
it's not
what
bright
we thought
pink.
It might be underneath there. And Andy and I thought maybe it'd be something real neat.
Similar.
Underneath.
Yeah. It's kind of. I don't
never know.
Right.
Well, and he took me back over back in the right hand corner up near the outside of the, and we pulled up part of the carpet, and that's what's under there. So my thought is, okay, you're going to have to take up that carpet to put new carpet down anyway and clean all the old glue and stuff off. Let's take it up, see what's under there. If it's nothing, we can, because it is, I mean, there's some places it does need replaced or something needs to be done there.
Is it anyway near close to your shirt color?
No, it's $11.
Well, that's a slam.
This is sad.
I was going to say.
Yeah.
It's closer to sand.
Anyway, is this the lower court?
Yes, lower two. Because, you know, we that's got that big beveled mount in there. And when we went on our full-scale tour, two things in that courtroom. One is the heating and cooling system. And then I'm sure they put the carpeting in at one time because it was probably the 60s, and that's what you did. You put carpeting and everything. You put paneling on everything. But now, you know, you kind of look at stuff and say, would it be okay, or is it too much of a noise aspect? And that's also why they put the carpeting in there, too. But at least to look underneath there and say, you know, if it would be like a really nice floor, like the rest of the floor is, we were thinking, why not try it for a while?
Right.
But we just didn't know what was underneath it.
Well, we pulled back the car and looked, and there's, I think it could be neat. I think it's worth a shot. That's what we were looking at the other day. And see how much it's worth under there. Just clean. You're going to have to clean it off anyway. Take it, look at it.
See
it. It's too noisy. I mean, you've got, when they initially did that, I assume they put the acoustic ceiling in at the same time they put the carpet. So you've got an acoustic ceiling, which will help dampen a lot of noise. I don't know. It's something to look at.
You could just put a runner right down the center. It's safety money.
Yeah, you could do
Safety money.
Yeah.
That safety money that... That was used up last fall or winter?
We still have plenty of it.
Yeah, we should. I mean, we picked up a lot more, unless we spent it, but I don't know.
That's not what it's called, but you know what I'm talking about.
Right. Illinois Public Risk.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, then, now, I am having, they're looking at putting a system better than what we've got, the two window air conditioners.
Right.
I'm having, and he's actually, he hadn't gotten me the actual estimate yet. Called and said that Mitsubishi makes a system, a split system, that you would put an air handler in the middle of that room. And it's $2,000 or $3,000 more than Daikon, I think, is the other manufacturer of those same types of systems. But I said, give me an estimate on both. And we'll look, and we can make up a decision. I know Mitsubishi's been in that business for a while, but so is the other, Daikon. But they've been in the business too for quite a while. So when he gets those to me, I'll bring that up. We can take a look at. And you had said something about maybe some of that money could be used for that, to put that system in.
That's just money that's been refunded to the county.
Yep.
So that's
right. So that carpet is a safety issue.
It is kind of, because now they've duct tape down in one place, and then they put a strip down there.
Somebody tripped on it the other day.
Yeah.
Hey, I didn't hear that.
You want to take care of the clientele that goes in and out of that room?
Yeah.
I think it was me.
I know what's coming.
Yeah. I don't think so.
So anyway, we may pull that up. Take a look at it, finish it, see what it looks like. It's bad. Then
courthouse roof repair could get pretty expensive.
I'm really concerned about it. The longer it takes, the worse it. But I was hoping to have something by now. He has been in contact with me and said we are working on it. So anyway, I'll let you know as soon as I know something.
Well, that could be funded another way if it had to be.
The roof?
If it doesn't get too out of hand.
Now, and I also want to look to see if there's any storm damage on it. I mean,
yeah,
how else do you, but I want that estimate before I can even do that.
Right.
But how else do you get broken slate up on top of the roof?
Age.
Well, So
have you got any broken slate? Yeah.
I didn't say anything after that, Dan. I've
been rusted off my house. I have some 20 or 30 year shingles. Said 20 years.
Somebody's up there playing ball on it.
Exactly right.
Somebody got just falls apart.
Damage.
Yeah.
All right.
That's about it.
That's Mr. Brenner.
We had a dog bite at the animal shelter. You're probably aware of it. Your sister was bitten.
Carl.
Twice.
That's not funny, Carl.
Jesus, Carl.
Have you ever talked to your sister?
Yeah,
I talked to her this weekend. She didn't say anything about it.
Yeah, she was serving papers for a dog at the homeowner's house, and she was in the house, and the pit bull bit her twice in the arm. So
is she okay?
Yeah.
She what happened to the pit bull?
She was taken to the emergency room. She had 2 puncture wounds.
But when did this happen?
It's been a couple weeks ago. The dog did have the shots on the FD quarantine.
I think she texted you about that, Carl.
I checked with her last week. She was fine.
Well, we're indiscriminate on attacks, aren't we?
But one of the dogs she was serving papers on was another dog that they had in the house that the lady lost control of and bit Linda twice.
Jeez.
So we'd probably get a workman's comp or something on the bill. So. Health department.
Goofy probably didn't know anything about it, either.
I don't know.
I haven't seen that come across. But...
we're back to square one on the replacing heat and cooling system. Andy and I had talked. We'd had an idea we wanted to simply put it out on bid and see what we would get with the contractor developing his own specs and then see if we can get something that would be within our price range. Told I couldn't do it that way. I was told I have to get an engineer first to develop the specs and then put that out on bid. Problem was the guy I talked to in Darrell said the going rate is 8 to 10% of the total project.
Sure.
So you're talking about $8,000, $10,000, $15,000 just for the engineering part. And
that's
then put it out on
bid. I have a question about all
that. I do too. I have a lot of questions.
Based on what you want to go first?
No, somebody like that.
Based on what we found out and what Alan sent us as far as, I mean, we really don't have anything to do with it.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. That's Ollie and Gang.
Yeah. Okay.
And I think that's pretty much.
I've done it in my lab and I've done a lot of work on it.
But that's, I mean, not that we don't appreciate, but I mean, that's got to be them. Mm-hmm. And I know they probably depended on you, but I mean, as part of that group, the only thing we can do is approve or not approve their budget. Mm-hmm. And beyond that.
If they want to continually patch up what they got, that's what they can do. If they want to put something else
in, it's their call. Yeah.
Just let us know what you're doing to the building. That's really all we need to know.
That's it. Yeah.
We are meeting next week. I'm going to lay it on the line, so you do what you want to do. If you want to use the Band-Aid fix, if it quits, then you got to replace it.
It's their decision.
Right. Also found out that professional services do not have to be put out on bid. So if you hire an engineer, it doesn't have to be put out on bid, but to me, a good idea to get 2 or 3 estimates if they want it done that way.
That's their decision, how they handle it.
All right, no good. So
we start making decisions for them, and we become.
Well, the other thing is they don't want to spend the money either. So.
Well,
it's their money.
They're not going to spend ours either.
Right. So that's just where we're at, and I'm kind of tired. So.
I bet.
So I'll just write on the line, so what do you want to do, and give it to Janet, and let her make a decision, and I'll make a decision. There should be grant money out for that anyway, and they really haven't worked on trying to find grants. So. But it's going to run between $150,000 and $1,000 probably to replace it. So. The whole system. So, that's where I'm at.
I already got my question about the airport thing yesterday. I've got one little quick thing for executive session. It won't take 10 minutes. And I had to have Aaron back in here to talk about. And then I'll be done.
Better let him know.
I already told him not to be flying out of here.
Carl, do you have anything you want to?
There is a 911 meeting this afternoon at 4:30. We need to get scheduled while we're all here. Sheriff's meeting.
Okay.
In the next week. What's your schedule?
I think I'm free. I'll check my calendar at my desk when I get back.
All this week?
I think I'm free.
Later in the week?
Yeah, I like to make it later as possible.
First part of next week, then?
I mean, late in the evening is what I'm talking about.
How late?
Oh, whatever you can tolerate.
How can you tolerate?
I'm fine.
Hey, let's go back to my old ways. We'll have it.
Yeah, we'll have it at 11 o'clock. That's fine.
You'd be awake about 1:30, so that'd work for me, too.
Yeah, okay. Well,
4 or 5 o'clock.
Let's say 5 o'clock would be fine. That's okay.
That's fine with me.
Okay.
Yeah, 5 will work for me.
Okay.
Next week,
nowhere.
can win.
What about this week?
I've got a meeting about every day this week.
Every evening?
Well, listen, let me check on Wednesday.
Check.
Well, Thursday I'm going to be out of town.
Well, it couldn't be Wednesday because we couldn't get it posted.
Right.
Yeah, we can. 5 o'clock. By 5 o'clock today.
Okay.
I just kind of bored that morning, I think. But yeah, 5 o'clock Wednesday evening would work for me, I think.
Okay, work for me.
Works for me.
Okay. Let's do it then.
Yep. By on Wednesday, you know, get back and check your desk, and if something conflicts, then we'll have to get the thing posted this afternoon. That's all I have.
Sheriff, you got anything you wanted to talk about?
Well, just the Carl brought up the union deal. I got a message this week from the William for the deputies union. He would like to meet, I believe it's July 15th at 11 o'clock.
July 15th?
At 11, I believe.
That's the week after the board meeting. At 11 o'clock?
Yeah, I'm thinking that's
Wednesday.
I'll double check when I'm checking on this other time, but I'm sure that's.
Let us know Wednesday.
Did I email him? But I'd get a hold of you guys. And
I put it in, so I can always change it.
Okay.
Okay.
It's hard to know. It's okay for me. Anything else, Jeff?
I think that's it right now.
Okay.
Where are we going to have this meeting? Courthouse?
Well, Crackman. No, Crackman.
Who's the line that we're going
to be here today?
Courthouse.
4:30?
Yeah.
And what about your sheriff's committee meeting this Wednesday?
Crackman.
You had Crackman too? Okay.
Does anybody else have anything? I've got several questions on some agenda stuff.
Carl, who's you, Jeff, and Ben?
Nope. I'm on the negotiation.
The sheriff's committee is Carl, me, and Jeff.
Yeah, well, I'm talking about for the negotiations.
Union. Carl, Dan, and
Farnham.
Farnham,
Carl, Dan, and Bruner.
Yeah.
Is that good?
Farnham,
Boyd, and Bruner put on the negotiation.
I'll go down. Just want to go over some of the agenda items and hit those. It may answer some of your questions. It may not. Number 7 is pretty self-explanatory. Please don't put this in yet. It's a surprise for Becky, but we've got a plaque ready for her. And let's see. Sheriff's report, clerk report. I've been working on dividing the precincts, Paris 5 and Sims, because they are in excess of 800. Working with the vendors, trying to find the most efficient and most effective way to do that. And well, I spent a lot of time on it, and I sent it to Mark. And in your packets, I gave you each a copy of his email. Now, I don't want to go over and I don't want you to read that now, but basically, what would appear to be fairly common sense in so many things doesn't turn out to be that way. And Mark has some questions, and as far as whether it's how we describe the precinct, whether it's meets and bounds, or how that all is worded, and if that's mandatory, and if that's what's the other word I lost there? You were shaking your phone. Does that mean anything?
No, just trying to get something.
Oh, I didn't know if you wanted me to hurry up.
No, absolutely not. Right. I enjoy listening to you.
All right. So, in theory, Sims, basically just going to take Sims Precinct and run it right down Route 1 from top of the township to the bottom of the township, splitting that in half east and west. And that will accomplish what the statutes require. Paris 5, I've looked at several different ways.
Do you know, by dividing Sims by Route 1, what's the, is like 200 and 600?
No, it's going to be, it's
fairly close.
4 1/4 to 380. That's what the statute says, is practically possible.
Mm-hmm.
So that's pretty easy in my mind, and just like I thought Paris 5 was going to be fairly easy, but I don't know, we're still working on the details. I don't know where I put it.
So Sims, it'll be Sims East, Sims West, but they still all vote at Sims Townhouse. And
Crispin and Ross 1 and Ross 2 be Sims 2.
Same thing that's going to happen with Paris 5.
Okay.
Except it's going to be north and south.
Because we're not adding more precincts, are we?
Well, I don't know how you divide them and not add them.
You can't put them into some other precinct? I mean, we're not going to have another polling place that we're going to have, are we?
No. We're not going to that extent. But it was suggested, or was brought to my attention, that by moving Paris 4 north, board representation would change.
It will.
And to avoid that, we looked at staying within the boundaries of 5, but creating 5 north and 5 south. Does that make any sense to anybody?
So you actually are creating another.
Evidently, that's what we're doing. And Mark has some questions.
Okay. Is this actually required?
Yes. Statute says when it reaches 800, that you need to divide it.
Okay.
But
I just wanted to know why we're doing this.
Well, right, it was brought to my attention by a concerned taxpayer.
I understand that, and that's fine, but that doesn't mean that it, you know.
Well, the statute's a statute.
Okay.
And
that's fine. That's your answer.
Is it necessary? Sure. Well, again, common sense, it's been working fine for years. But we need to make it right. The question that Mark has in the statute, it refers to creating districts versus creating precincts. And there has to be more research done in that.
So I was just wondering why this isn't done every 10 years as opposed to piecemeal in the middle, which just costs a lot of time and effort that we don't have the money to cover.
Every 10 years we reapportion. We did. Paris 5 did not at that time, for whatever reason, did not get realigned like it probably should have.
Okay.
There isn't any. I guess I'm just wondering if we do that, Augie, I'm wondering out loud here. If we're really not creating an additional precincts, to where somebody's going to come back and say, oh, now we need additional judges for that, which, you know, from my standpoint, I don't know why we don't have more centralized voting places.
Well, that's not going to change, Alan.
But how can it not?
Well, you're right. We are going to be creating a new precinct because you have to divide
it. You're 5A and 5B, type thing.
If you divide it, then yes, you have a new one now. That theoretically requires new separate election judges.
Oh, even in the same precinct voting.
We cluster our precincts into polling places, we can manage.
You can leave it like it is. That's what you think at this
point. I believe I can leave it like it is.
You leave it like it is, call for a ballot from north or south.
Whether you walk in and ask for a ballot from Hunter, Stratton, or Elbridge.
Can Mark make the case that this you know, since it was overlooked, we can just wait for the next census?
We'd have to ask Mark that question. He is of the opinion that
probably not.
If we don't get it done, the statute calls for the June meeting. Okay. That the county board shall. And if you don't do it, then you got to do it by the next June meeting.
What happens to us if we don't do it?
Well, I don't. Nothing.
So within the state statutes, then anytime a precinct gets over 800 voters, mm-hmm. technically by once you find out about it, technically by the next June, you have to realign.
That's what it says.
That defeats that whole purpose every right. 10 years.
Besides, it screws up the districts, which we set every 10 years.
That's what it says.
And then there'll have to be from Sims Township, there'll have to be a precinct committeeman from yep. each.
Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
And then you're going to have to just... have, not only that, I think you're setting a...
But it's nothing to mess up Andy's district, does it? You still
No, not the way you're doing it. It doesn't, correct?
No, it will, because if you're a precinct committeeman, you're only going to go to the highway.
But the county board member.
Yeah.
The county board the county district.
The county board district does not change.
Does not change.
Okay. Nothing it changes just, as far as
It just gives you another precinct in your district. Like for mine, 5. So I'm going to have 5A and 5B, or 5 North and 5 South, or 5 East and 5 West. But I think that kind of circumvents.
But they're all going to vote at the same place, just like they have. So.
I'm sure if you look back through it, there's probably something that has to do with the amount of representation that someone can logically handle. Or
how much are we over?
915 is our total in Paris 5.
So it's a bunch.
We got to get it down to 600.
I swear it was more than
or near. Yeah. First one. And Sims is 812, something like that.
All right.
So I'm working on it, but when Ben Cree and I worked on the agenda, we put it on there.
So it. The state's attorney might not have it resolved by Wednesday.
That is a very likely possibility.
Okay.
So we'll have to wait for another year.
Well, or we'll do it sooner. I mean,
nothing says we can't have a special meeting and do it.
So then that brings. So if we did it next year, then we got the primary and then the general election. I mean, there's.
Well, that's my concern. Now's as good as time to legality by, I mean, is it something, that's the only real tough question. Is there some illegality in not having that done by
election? I guess we could have a taxpayer suit.
We could have a taxpayer suit brought against us. But we certainly wouldn't expect that and hope that that wouldn't happen.
Well, and it'd take 2 years for it to, you know, the election.
We'll be here anyway.
So we're just waiting to hear. We'll have to wait to hear from
Mark and I got to get back together. Yes.
All right.
Ben also asked me to put on here to appoint county board or health board of health members.
Are they not on a rotating basis?
Now they are.
Well, for some reason, over the years, they just some of them were missed and some of them were caught. And what we did in January was just got everybody squared up, if you will. And these were the four who are up in 15, and then the remaining are up in 16. Now, if there's a desire to, again, that's the county board chairman's right to appoint. If he wants it 1 year, 2 year, 3 year terms and do all that. But my understanding was that's the way he wanted that.
Right.
I know there's something else back here.
The poker room.
Yes.
What's that about?
Well, that's another one of those things that you guys have to think, decide if that's what you want to do or not. Some people have asked about them. This was came up last summer, I think, this whole thing. But the law was rewritten, or the raffle law statute was amended to now include poker run. So it's called the raffle and poker run law, if you will, just to paraphrase it. And I put all that stuff in your board packets, and it's too much to read now. And I also gave you Mark's comments in there to me. And number one, we have an old raffle policy that would still work, but doesn't include poker runs. And Alan, the samples that you provided us from the new CCI, Mark thought would be very acceptable if the board wanted to include poker rounds. Now, surprisingly, a lot of the counties around don't have any ordinances for poker rounds. And I'm not saying that's right, wrong, but there are poker runs that are going on all over the place, but they've never come in and asked for a license in my office.
So that's like these motorcycle people doing all these things. So now they have to come in and pay a fee and do all kinds of...
Technically, that's right.
Well, because it's revenue.
Because it's revenue.
It's gambling, basically.
And normally they're for the benefit of...
Right. That's right.
Somebody who's unfortunately sick, or memorial, or...
The maximum fee that I can charge for one of these is $25.
What's the minimum?
I think it's...
Zero.
$5, maybe? And I don't know that there is a minimum.
We'll pay for it for $25. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's, and there's a lot in there, too, yeah.
Does this have to be done Wednesday?
No, it doesn't have to. I wish Ben were here that he could give us his thoughts. But I had another individual, a specific example, who brought this to me in May, and I said, there's no time to get it on the agenda in May. Wanted to poke around. Well, he said, okay, that's fine. So I gave it to Mark to look at. Well, you know how everybody's busy. Well, then he called me a couple weeks ago and he said, hey, where are we at on this? Are we going to get it done in time, which would actually be for this weekend coming up? I said, well, I don't know. What's the deal? Well, they've got one, and I forget now who it's for, but the example he gave me was, I think there was a run for Shauna Morrison. And it ended up in Clark County instead of her hometown, Edgar County, because the people on the run wouldn't come into the county because there's no license for that. And now that was one event. So, but that's what I said. There are runs going on. You see them. I mean, they're just everywhere. And that's all. Ben said, let's put it on. We can talk about it if we table it, or we can act on it. It's whatever we want to do. The reading material is in your packet.
We'll read it.
Yeah. Let's see, what else would you like me to tell you?
Can you say no license needed? Is that even possible?
Well, the...
No county.
I think the statute says, I mean, you've got to have a license, but I think it comes more back to charging nothing for it. I mean, you're taking away money for the actual cause of the benefit.
We'll look at it.
And if we ain't hinging on two or three poker runs a year to keep us out of
financial
ruin, we're in a world
with something that isn't broke.
Yeah.
That I agree. I'm the messenger.
No, no, that's we understand.
That's the state rule.
Yeah.
Was there a liability issue there? Is that part of it? I mean, that would be my only concern.
I think the biggest part is the state of Illinois came out and said, it was brought up to them, so naturally we have to act on it. So naturally then what happens?
You get a little jump.
We have to act on it.
That's right.
I mean, that.
It flows downhill.
You had inter-county, you had interstate lines, and it was like, whereas it's, you're going to charge somebody $25 to do this, and there probably is a liability. That'd be my concern, is like, there's probably a liability if we don't do it.
That's,
and then you're negligent by default or something bizarre.
That's my only.
You don't know.
I think that's it for me.
Are we going to go into?
Mr. Chairman?
Jeff, can I ask something on this point? Do we need, based on this, do we also need to talk about adding on to the reason and collective negotiation matters between public body and employees, and also possibly, I don't know what else, setting a price?
I was going to read the whole thing.
Well, I'm talking, those aren't the things in here, though. Some of these aren't. The one about collective negotiations.
You don't want to talk about collective negotiations.
No, that's what I'm asking. Also, do we want to talk about setting a price or sale of property owned by a public body? You're not at that point yet.
No.
You're talking about your other issue.
Okay.
Okay.
That's a good point.
I just want to make sure.
Mr. Chairman, I move we go in a closed session, discuss appointments, employment, compensation, discipline, performance, and or dismissal of specific employees of public body, pending litigation, and review of closed session minutes. Well, I'll forget the closed session minutes.
Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Same time. Okay. Executive session.
Do you need Aaron?
I need Aaron.
Yeah. All the time, correct? Somebody, no?
Someone's up in the daytime for some reason.
We need to go back.
We're back in open session. Does anybody else have anything else?
That was something Ollie had asked me. He goes, you know, if you got cars that are sitting up there, can you sit them out at the hospital?
Let's go out of session.
Okay. If there's no more business, do I have a motion to adjourn?
I make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
All those in favor, aye.
Aye.
All the same side.
Wait a minute. Gonna shut that off?
Yes, sir, I am. Are we all good?
Yeah.
I thought you were talking to me to wait a minute.